New Leaf had brought many new lives to Branch Clan, and the clan was beginning to feel the strain. Although there were still plenty of fish to catch in the waters off of the beaches, there were fewer and fewer warriors able to catch them now that so many of Branch Clan's best hunters were expecting queens. Queens with tempers that were growing shorter and shorter while their appetites were growing larger and larger. That also meant there were fewer cats available to patrol the territories and defend the borders, a fact that Branch Star had been increasingly aware of.
What about Wildpaw and Stonepaw? Do you think they are ready to be made warriors?
Quelai meowed. Branch Star glanced at his best friend and deputy, narrowing his eyes. Quelai's voice sounded like a croaking frog, and his dusky, gray fur stuck up in odd places, unkept. Branch Star sighed and forced the fur to settle on his neck, striving to control his own stress at Branch Clan's current strain. Quelai had been distracted and seemed harried lately, not sleeping well and patrolling the boundaries of the clan territory on his own at night.
I'm sorry, Quelai. I know the strain has been getting to you as well.
Branch Star shook his head, feeling a flicker of pride. Quelai was clearly doing the best he could to step up and serve as one of the few senior warriors of the clan who were not in the nursery, despite the fact his mate Otterslip was due to have kits any day.
And I think Wildpaw would be ready to become a warrior by now, honestly. She was so close, but after the snake bite, it just doesn't seem like she's as strong. It might be quite some time before she's able to become a warrior, at this rate. But Stonepaw...
Branch Star narrowed his eyes, his tail dancing behind him as he sorted his thoughts.
Perhaps Stonepaw is ready soon. I'll speak with Nightfrost and...
Branch Star! Branch Star!
Trout Shadow's voice burst through the bushes by the cave entrance, followed shortly by a harried Trout Shadow himself, leaves sticking out of his fur from all directions. Although Trout Shadow was an increasingly talented hunter, he was easily distracted and didn't quite have the air of respectful presence that the other senior cats did, especially not with the fish scales on his face from an interrupted meal and leaves tangled in his long fur. Before Branch Star could chide Trout Shadow on his grooming habits, the Siamese-colored cat finally caught his breath.
Branch Star! There are intruders!
What are you doing here?
Branch Star's voice was flat and cold, but not hostile. Briarstalk's eyes flashed as he looked up at the Branch Clan leader, flexing his shoulders slightly, as though to show off the powerful muscles that were under his ginger coat.
We came to see how Crowfeather is doing, of course,
Briarstalk replied, forcing a friendly tone to his voice.
Unless, perhaps, you aren't even allowing him to have visitors?
Briarstalk let his question hang in the air, and Branch Star bristled at the accusations hidden within, though his reply was calm.
Crowfeather is not a prisoner here.
Branch Star's tail twirled once, but he remained calm.
Of course, you are welcome to visit him. I believe you'll find that he has been treated with all the respect and generosity that Branch Clan has to offer its clan members.
Branch Star nodded towards Crowfeather, who was standing behind him with Sea Whisper and the other Branch Clan cats by his side.
See for yourself. And since you've come all this way down from the forest,
Branch Star narrowed his eyes, glancing over Briarstalk and Oakpaw.
You might as well stay for a moment. You'll find our beaches safe and plenty of fish in our prey pile, as always. Branch Clan has much to offer those who live in its caves.
With a stiff nod, Branch Star left Briarstalk, waving his tail to indicate Crowfeather was allowed forward to speak with his Moss Clan clanmates. Crowfeather hesitated for a moment, and then dashed up to Briarstalk and Oakpaw, his tail high and his eyes bright.
You came! I'm sorry I've not visited yet. There has been, a lot going on.
Crowfeather glanced over his shoulder at Sea Whisper, who had turned and was staring towards the beach with a distant expression. He tilted his head in confusion and then shrugged, looking back towards Briarstalk.
It is so good to see you. How are you? How is Moss Clan doing? I've got so many fish to give you guys. It will fill the prey pile to the treetops.
It is good to see you too, Crowfeather.
Briarstalk meowed, relief in his voice.
And good to hear you talk of Moss Clan like that. We know you're loyal at heart and will come back to us. Greenleaf will be here soon, after all.
Briarstalk purred and butted Crowfeather's side with his head, missing the confused expression that crossed the young black and white cat's face.
How are things here? How have they been treating you? When you didn't visit for a long time, we were worried that they were holding you hostage.
Oh no, I'm fine, really. It's just been, well, busy. This clan is bursting at the seams with so many hits, so a bit of extra help has been needed to keep an eye on them.
Crowfeather shifted his paws in the grass, trying to ignore his racing heart. Why was he so nervous?
Briarstalk laughed, his eyes distant for a moment, as the memory of Kits stirred up old memories.
Kits. Well, they can keep any clan on their toes, it seems. I take it none of them are yours?
Briarstalk asked, a teasing tone in his voice. Crowfeather burst out laughing, feeling his nervousness drain away as his old friend traded jokes with him.
No, no, trust me, none of them are mine, though I did help out a kit called Shell Kit the other day.
Stonepaw. Branch Star looked over the young cat in front of him, noting with a distant sense of pride how the quiet young cat had grown into a fairly strong, sturdy warrior. He had guided his son through the bushes, away from the visitors, and into a more private area.
Now is not the time for MossClan to know how difficult it has been to keep the prey pile full. We still have plenty of fish along the beaches, after all, even if there are less paws to catch them.
Branch Star sighed, flicking his tail at the odd problem of having so many good fishing cats in the nursery.
I want you to go and work with the Stone Spirit. For as long as Briarstalk and Oakpaw are here, keep the prey pile full as possible. I believe this is something that you can do to help the clan in your own way. Do you understand?
Branch Star hesitated, then nodded to himself.
In fact, if you do this, I think it may be time to make you a warrior.
Stonepaw let out a soft gasp, and his fur prickled for a moment, then settled, and he nodded firmly.
I may need to travel along the edges of our territory to get enough stones. We've used up many of the ones here in the caves.
Stonepaw meowed, his voice serious as he thought through the task in front of him. Branch Star was proud to see how his son was more focused on his task, rather than the possibility of getting his warrior name.
That's fine. You have permission to travel along the edges of our territory, or even beyond, as needed. Just be sure to take Nightfrost with you if you wander too far.
I am not sure I should, Stonepaw meowed, frowning. She has seemed extremely tired lately. I heard Bearglow telling her that she needed to rest more often, but I'm not sure why.
Stonepaw trailed off, staring into space as he tried to chase down the thread of that memory about his mentor.
What?
Branchstalk flicked his ears, a flash of annoyance in his voice.
I understand if she is tired too. We all are, but every capable warrior needs to be working hard to help the clan right now. We don't have time for naps. Tell her she is to assist you as well. Understand?
I understand, Branchstar.
Stonepaw's voice was troubled, but he dipped his head respectfully to his clan leader and father and left to find Nightfrost.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to Sims 3, The Warrior Cats Challenge. And we are still at Branch Clan right now, but we have some Moss Clan visitors. So, because it is getting very close to Greenleaf, the summertime, when Crowfeather needs to make his decision about which clan he is going to stay in, and because they haven't seen him for a long time, Briarstalk and Oakpaw have actually come over, and they are checking in on Crowfeather, and Branch Star was a bit confident enough to tell them that they can stay for a little while. Since they've come all this way, all the way down from the ruined forest of Moss Clan, they might as well stay and fill their bellies on some of the extremely abundant fish that Branch Clan always has. And he's really confident that this visit will go well, and that it'll be a good time for Briarstalk to see how Crowfeather has settled in, and Oakpaw will see how Crowfeather has settled in, and Crowfeather might be reminded of the abundance and the things that Branch Clan can offer its clan members. So we have that. So we've got Branch, they look so similar. We've got Crowfeather visiting with Briarstalk and Oakpaw over here. Apparently Slate is catching an outstanding jellyfish. The sight of the fish's smooth scales won't be forgotten soon. Slate, jellyfish don't have scales. I'm sorry to break it to you, buddy, but it's true. So that's what's going on over there. We actually have little Shellkit over here. He's snoozing. And somebody suggested, by the way, that what if Shellkit, because he almost drowned, because we had that random event roll where one of the kits almost drowned in the ocean and it was Shellkit. What if Shellkit now has a fear of the water? And I thought that was pretty interesting, except that Shellkit does have some personality traits. So just so you guys know, I have rolled for personality traits on all of the kits that are more than the ones that the game comes with, so that they're kind of more personalized personality traits, so we get to know them as characters and not just their abilities that they have as like Sims animals. So Shellkit is actually stubborn. That's one of his personality traits. He is stubborn, materialistic, and observant. And his main goal in life is eventually going to be kind of finding love, whatever form that's going to come in. And as a materialistic sort of cat, maybe he'll just have a love of all the shiny things that he can collect. So that's Shellkit. And I think because he is so stubborn that he wouldn't be deterred from trying to jump into the water and back into the sea. So that's him. And all of the kits are going to have these personality traits rolled for them at birth now. So we kind of get a sense of their character, and they're not just like mindlessly running around being cute until they grow up and they can do something useful. So we will be giving them a little bit more so of some fleshed out personalities as time goes on using random personality generators that I find online, because they're amazing. I love random generators. All right, so moving on from that, Stonepaw has also been given a very, very special task from his father. So Stonepaw has been told that if he actually goes and he befriends Slate, so that's kind of his goal to get his warrior cat name, is to befriend Slate and become best friends with Slate and to keep the prey pile full of fish for the next day, for the entire time that we have Briarstalk and Oakpaw visiting. We want to show off how abundant all of the fish are for Branch Clan. And so he's got to keep the prey pile full of fish and full of prey. And in order to do that, he needs to become best friends with Slate. I don't think he's best friends yet. They're just friends. So he needs to become best friends with Slate, and he also needs to go around and collect up stones to give Slate so that Slate can put tons and tons of fish into the prey pile and impress the Moss Clan visitors. That's kind of the goal there. And then let's see, anything else going on? Dawnstep is kind of relaxing a little bit. She's still feeling a little bit down. She wants to catch a rodent, possibly to feed her kits. She's still sort of depressed and withdrawn. We also have Sea Whisper. Sea Whisper has currently eaten 2 damselfish, and so we really want to see if Sea Whisper can have more damselfish. If she can have 3, then that will protect her unborn kits. She almost miscarried all of her kits last time, and that was really dramatic. And as long as she has the fairy damselfish, then her kits have a 50-50 chance of surviving birth. And as long as she has enough rainbow shells, so as long as she's got these rainbow snails, then we can use those on her kits even if they don't survive birth. So it's a little bit tentative, and we're starting to run very low on rainbow shells. We've already used up quite a few of them. In fact, I think, yeah, we've got Sea Whisper has a couple, and then it looks like Crowfeather actually has a couple, but he doesn't know that they might be needed for potentially his kits. So I don't think he would give them to Branch Clan unless, like, you know, Sea Whisper had her kits right in front of him and one almost dies, and then he would like hand it over. But is she going to have the kits before he leaves? Is he going to leave? Is he going to stay? Is she going to tell him? So that's what's going on with Sea Feather. So there is quite a bit. Nightfrost is not feeling very well. She's very tired, just kind of feeling run down. Her immune system doesn't seem as good. She's getting fleas a lot, which is really making Bearglow quite upset. Bearglow hates fleas. It's like a personal pet peeve he has. So Bearglow is going to be trying to get rid of the fleas today. Stonepaw is going to be gathering as many stones as possible and really working with Slate today to keep the fish in the prey pile. And Briarstalk and Oakpaw are currently allowed to hang out in the clan. So we'll kind of see how that goes, and we'll see which cats they want to interact with. Oakpaw, who do you want to interact with? Oh, he wants to sniff... he's going to go catch a fish? What? He wants to try his paws at catching a fish. Well, that's amazing. All right. And Wildpaw is just ignoring him and coming over to sharpen her claws. I don't think she's going to be very pleased that her brother is actually having an opportunity to go and potentially earn his warrior cat name before her. So we'll have to see how she's going to take that. Let's see, Crowfeather's doing okay. Nightfrost, how are you doing? You guys doing okay? All right, we'll send him off. Let's see, sniff Oakpaw. Maybe he'd politely say hello to Oakpaw really quickly. All right, there's Moonpaw napping. But we will... There's a salmon. Now, a salmon has scales, Slate, so you're okay on that one. And then, yeah, we do need to cure these fleas. So we'll work with Bear Glow to do that. In fact, I wonder if Bear Glow would do that really quickly before they leave so that she's not quite so exhausted and feeling quite so sick. So Bear Glow, come over here. And let's see, how bad is the flea infestation she has? Oh, good. It's just a light infestation. So we only need one. Yeah, we've got it. All right, he's going to come over and he's going to groom her and tell Stonepaw he can just wait a second. So Stonepaw, come over here. Scratch this. You take care of that. And then it looks like there's tons and tons of fish in here right now. So Dawnstep is taking care of some of that. What is she eating? Apparently she likes minnows. She must not have much of an appetite right now. But I also noticed how Stonepaw has been catching a lot of birds. Common birds, but he's been catching goldfinches and pigeons and parakeets. So I thought that was kind of interesting. He even caught a water beetle. Is anybody going to eat the water beetle? I'll go ahead and add them in just in case anybody wants to eat them. There we go. So Stonepaw's probably pretty proud that he's been doing that at least. All right, and Nightfrost, we're going to have you taken care of by Bear Glow. So the new way we're handling flea infestations, and because I am obsessed with random generators, is I'm rolling a dice, and anywhere between 1 and 3 is the strength of the flea infestation. A 3 means you have to use 3 items to cure the fleas. A 1 means you only have to use 1 item to cure the fleas. What items you use vary depending on what the medicine cat's skills are and what their knowledge is. And Bear Glow is knowledgeable with sea sludge, so he's going to get rid of Nightfrost fleas with the 1 sea sludge that he has, which will hopefully help her feel a little bit better, because she's really not feeling well lately, before they head off over searching for rocks, probably over by the temple again. All right, and Branch Star, you don't have any food on you, and you do want to give a gift. You do want to check on Shell Kit. Where's Otter Slip? Because she's going to have her kits pretty soon, be pounced on. Let's go ahead and actually, can I buy a new thing? Hey, Otter Slip, there we go. Don't mind that. That's just me buying a new scratching post because they destroy it so often. I'm going to actually have him come over and sniff Otter Slip to very politely inquire how she's feeling and how her kits are doing. And then how are you guys doing? All right, still grooming. All right, off you go. Off you go, Branch Star. And then, oh, what's this? Trout Shadow, you are so lucky that Misty Pond's brother is busy, like, grooming someone and he totally missed that. All right, and Misty Pond's going to go play with Dawnstep and Wild Paw. And where are our guests? So it seems like Briarstalk is not really willing to try out fish. He's actually more interested in just eating the beetle. So something he's familiar with, because I guess there's pretty much nothing to eat but beetles in Moss Clan right now. But he might hang out with some of the cats over here. Do you want to do anything? Let's see. It seems like Sea Whisper just wants to nuzzle with Otter Slip. So everybody is suddenly concerned about Otter Slip. And Briarstalk, let's actually grab... Where's Oakpaw? Oakpaw, you're in the medicine den. I don't think that's going to go over well if you're caught in there. So let's have him go interact with Moonpaw, maybe some of the other apprentices. And this is really cute. Look, he wants to sniff Red Kit and Robin Kit. So we'll remember that Oakpaw is a good big brother and he's curious about his brother, how his siblings are doing. And then I don't think it's a good idea for you to go and chase Wildpaw, even if you are feeling a little lonely. So let's have Oakpaw come over and sniff her. And then Wildpaw, what am I going to do with you? Playfully chase Otter Slip, improve hunting skill, catch a bird. I think she might try to do a little bit of hunting. Her hunting skill, as you guys know, was extremely decreased because she got bitten by that venomous snake and lost the fight with it. And so she had a lot of venom in her body, and she went from hunting skill level 7 to hunting skill level 3 to show the effects of how her body was so weakened. All right, and Crowfeather, what do you want to do? Oh, Crowfeather wants to playfully pounce Briarstalk, and he wants to be friends with Briarstalk. All right, Briarstalk. Oh, look, and Briarstalk's coming out into, like, scratching post. Oh, Slate caught a big giant redfish at the same time. So Briarstalk, we're going to have you come over here, and Crowfeather come over here, and we'll have to see... You know, I bet one of the things that should probably decide everything is who Crowfeather is closest to in terms of relationships before this is all said and done. So let's have him go ahead and socialize, and then we'll have him playfully pounce, I think is what he wanted to do. Playfully, is that playfully pounce? Yeah, playfully pounce. So we'll have him come over, play, pounce, and then maybe they'll share tongues for a little while, because that is something the cats would normally do on a day like this. All right, and actually, I think you, sir, socialize with Briarstalk. Visit the beach. You're kind of at the beach, so I'm just gonna kind of say that one's full because he's sort of at the beach. And then, yeah, Wild Paw is hunting. Stone Paw, you're actually going to head off with Night Frost in a second. All right. And Branch Star, I've got to start focusing on one cat again, like just one set of cats again, because it gets a little bit confusing. All right, I think it's time to do some hunting. So I think he would come over and he would bring Moonpaw over to do some hunting. Unfortunately, Branch Star is often caught up with all of his kits and all of the clan drama, so he doesn't often remember to be a very good mentor, because he's just sort of being yanked in so many different directions all at the same time. All right, are you guys almost done? Like, I'm pretty sure that Stonepaw is ready to get a move on here. I'm pretty sure those fleas are gone now, and Nightfrost is about to, like, pass out. So, all right, Nightfrost, you go ahead and scratch that a little bit. Stonepaw, I guess you can go ahead and take a nap till she's done. And Barely, you can't get hairballs because you're a medicine cat, so you lucked out there. All right, what does he want to do? Improve hunting skill. And he actually wants to practice on a toy. So we'll let him go ahead and do that. All right, and then we're going to focus on Stonepaw and Nightfrost because it is... Oh, and Wildpaw caught an empty chip bag. It is a big deal for him to potentially get... And Misty Pond's freaking out. His warrior cat name today, if that happens. So he needs to become friends with Slate. Oh, I guess I could have had him... Moonpaw caught a piranha. Why does she go after these risky rare things? I don't have the generator made yet, Moonpaw, or else he might be in trouble. So let's stop that. Nightfrost, are you almost done? Oh, wow, she's really exhausted. But it was an order from Branch Star to go, so let's get them up to the temple. And then what I think can happen... All right, sorry, Nightfrost. What I think can happen is... As her worried apprentice... Ah, what's this? Oh, yeah, this is... We own it, so it has a different marking. But I think as her worried apprentice, what Stonepaw would suggest is that Nightfrost take a nap. Nightfrost just take a nap and rest while he does a little bit of hunting and gathering of stones. So we'll leave them there. Oh, Nightfrost has gained the non-destructive trait. Branch Star just caught a fairy damselfish. Oh, I think Seafeather might come up and ask him for it. Or she might get it from Bearglow. I have a feeling she'd probably get it from Bearglow. So that would be another fairy damselfish that she could eat and potentially, like, keep her kits alive with. Wonderful. We're helping the unborn kits. That's a good thing. All right. So a piranha. I can't believe she caught a piranha. That's pretty hilarious. And then let's see, anybody else we need to worry about? I'm really curious about what Briarstalk is up to and where he's headed off to. Oh, he's still just sharing tongues. And he does want to go ahead and socialize with like Honeywish, and he wants to socialize with Stonepaw. We'll worry about that in a little bit. So he's not gonna be the main thing I'm gonna focus on. Really, I kinda wanna focus on Oakpaw. I wanna see what Oakpaw is going to make of his opportunity. Nah, what's happening? Oh, Branch Star! No way! Wow, level 10 of the hunting skill? That's awesome! Wow, we should give him a reward. He actually should get a reward. I'm going to say that definitely earns the alpha pet for having level 10 of the hunting skill. And wow, I mean, I feel like we should get him some sort of something. Attitude adjustment, never nauseous. Maybe we should spend some money on these best behavior, still bladder. You know what? Let's get him the still bladder. That actually makes it so that cats never have to pee, which sounds ridiculous, but he's also a super controlled, like, leader. So I could see that happening. All right, we're going to have you sniff Branch Star. Oh, he wants to sniff his brother. He's so worried about his siblings and Silverfang. Oh. But I think he would actually come over and spend a little bit of time socializing with the Branch Clan leader, partially to try to be polite, but also because he just witnessed some pretty awesome hunting skills that he wants to learn a little bit more about. All right. Wildpaw, what are you doing? I missed this battle, this epic battle you were apparently having with the snake. Is that Bearglow? Yeah, that's Bearglow, so he's still practicing. Oh, and he's curious. You know, he really doesn't like Oakpaw. I almost forgot about that. He really doesn't like Oakpaw. But he might be a little worried about his sister getting so close to Dawnstep. And Dawnstep is curious about Trout Shadow, Briarstalk. She wants to catch a rodent. She can't catch a rodent, though. So we're going to have to leave that be. And then it looks like she wants to take care of her kits, actually. Nuzzle with sand kit. So I think it's probably time for her to focus on her kits, actually. She would forget about the new people and she'd want to focus on her kits. And I think Misty Pond is going to get caught by her brother playing with the enemy, in his opinion. So he would probably focus on playing with Misty, playing with Misty Pond right now. All right, playfully chase. Dawnstep, I'm going to go ahead and have you. Where are you going, Crowfeather? Just gonna go scratch things, that's fine. Dawnstep, where are your kits? Like, I really should find where the heck your kits are. Okay, just check it out, Trout Shadow. So Trout Shadow's checking out what Sand Kit's up to. And is Sand Kit the one you wanna cuddle with, Dawnstep?
So many kits.
It is. All right, friendly Nuzzle. Friendly Groom. So I'm gonna have Dawnstep hang out with her kits. And back at home, or back over here, good. Nightfrost is getting the nap that she desperately needs. And Stonepaw is going to go around looking for these rocks. And it doesn't look like there are that many. But I think he's going to start roaming far and wide looking for them. So that he can hopefully manage to get his warrior cat name. So until tomorrow at about 6 in the morning, we need to keep the prey pile more or less completely full. And that's going to require... Come here, Slate. You're spirit of the land, so you don't really have needs. That's going to require interacting with Slate over here. And let's offer him present. He's going to present a feather as a gift to Slate. There we go, Slate. We have feather. Will you please take it? What, you won't react? You won't react to it? It was a lovingly given to you feather from our little cat here. Come on. Come on. We're gonna here, have a feather. Come on, Slate. Aw, Slate! Yay! Alright, so that counted. And meanwhile, Wildpaw is not catching anything. That's so sad. Alright, then we'll collect this. And we might even have Stonepaw, now that I think about it, we might have Stonepaw work on his relationship for a minute. So maybe mark, sniff, maybe play. Yeah, he might play or even be brushed. There we go. We might have him kind of interact like that with Slate because they do need to get their relationship up to best friends as well. That's another goal that they have. So we'll go ahead and leave those guys to it. Then we've got Mama Cat over here. Speaking of Mama Cat, let's see what Otter Slip wants out of life. Oh, that's what Otter Slip wants out of life. Okay, you guys. It's time for some newborn kits. And look at this, Quillay is right here to be by his mate's side as these little one or ones are born. Oh my gosh. Okay, get ready for this, you guys.
What is wrong with my kit? Otterslip gasped, her voice hoarse with exhaustion. He looked fine, and then all of a sudden he started shaking. Bearglow, what has happened to him?
Otterslip trembled from her place in the medicine cat moss bed, the exhaustion of having just given birth leaving her too tired to move despite her panic. Bearglow narrowed his eyes and sniffed the newly born tomkit in front of him. Just moments ago, the tomkit had been trembling violently, jerking against the moss bed where he had been quietly nursing next to his sister. Nothing about his birth had seemed out of place, and yet...
He may have a condition, Bearglow murmured, almost to himself. Beside him were the remains of a rainbow shell that he had crushed and force-fed to the kit once it was clear the kit was losing the ability to breathe. After that, the shaking had stopped, and the kit had fallen asleep, exhausted from its life and death struggle after having just been born. Otterslip let out a tiny, frightened meow, and Quail Eye made a choking sound, his expression bleak. Their joy at their newly born kits had evaporated as soon as the tomkit had started jerking against Otterslip's side.
Will he be all right now? Quail Eye finally said, his voice frail.
Bearglow flicked his tail, watching the tiny kit before him with a distant gaze.
I am not sure. I have seen conditions like this before. It may return. If that is the case, we will have to be sure to have many rainbow snails on hand, or...
Bearglow let his voice trail off, silence filling the den, as all the cats there realized just how bleak the future was for this tiny tomkit.
All right, everyone, and welcome back. So, Otterslip has finally had her long-awaited kits, the little ones that she has been waiting for so long for after losing her first two kits. And she almost lost her Tom kit. So she has had two little kits. She has had a little boy right here, a little Tom kit, and a little girl right over here. And she would be snuggling with her parent, with Otterslip in the moss bed in the medicine den, except for the fact you can only snuggle with one kit at a time. So this little boy is the one who did roll something pretty special. He actually almost died after he was born because he has quite a few seizures. And so that's his special event, his medical modifier that almost killed him as a kit, and Berglow stepped in and had to use a rainbow snail to keep him from dying. So this little kit, his name is actually Glow Kit, because Otterslip named him after Berglow because she looks up to Berglow so much, and then Berglow ended up saving his life. Now, something interesting about Glow Kit, not only does he have the seizures, he's going to have those seizures the entire time he is a kit, and once a day he is going to have a 10% chance of having another deadly seizure. And if we have a rainbow shell on hand, then that's really awesome, and we should be able to use the rainbow shell to keep him alive. And if we don't have a rainbow shell on hand, or a rainbow fish, or a fairy damsel, or anything that's needed to keep kits alive, then there's a chance that he might pass away. So he's not out of the woods until he grows up and outgrows his kithood seizures, but he does have that issue going on for him. And he also has some very interesting personality traits that I think, if he survives, might prove to be a bit of trouble for Berglow. Not only is he Berglow's namesake as Glow Kit, but he also is a compassionate, sly, and dependable cat. So those are his personality traits that he's been born with, who has the desire to pursue knowledge. So he's a cat who would be after knowing everything there is to know, and, you know, Berglow has a lot of secrets, and I could see a compassionate cat, who's also very sly, working to figure out all of those little secrets that Berglow is hiding. So we'll have to see what happens with Glow Kit. So that's Glow Kit, and then right over here, we have our little girl. I have no idea why she has a smush face, and actually, there was a bit of a silly joke right after she was born, passed between Otterslip and Quail Eye, where Otterslip joked, "Oh, look at her smushed face. She looks like if you and Dawnstep had a kit," that just about made Quail Eye pass out right there on the spot while she was like cleaning her newborn kitten. But this is little Coral Kit. So this is Coral Kit. I'm hoping she'll grow into her face. I have no idea where it came from, but she's just really beautiful, a very healthy little kit. And her traits are considerate, brilliant, and depressed. And she also has the desire to pursue love when she gets older. What kind of love? Who knows? Maybe a bitter sweet tragic love, and that's why she has the trait of occasionally being pretty depressed or just very kind of down, not really happy, gloomy. She's got a gloomy trait. So these are our two newest little ones. I'm so excited that they're part of the family. Oh my goodness, and what's going on here? This is actually my fault because I was, we're just not gonna count this as a roll because that's my fault. I was distracted and doing the little video thing and not paying attention. So I'll take care of this kit. We don't need you, Shell Kit. You're so stubborn. We don't need you to cause any trouble. But yeah, that's actually my fault because I was doing movie scenes. So we're going to ignore that one. And then we're going to pop back over to Stonepaw, who actually had a special event just happen. He has now chosen Slate as his BFF. So that's pretty good. That means that as far as Stonepaw is concerned, things are advancing with Slate. And he's going to start running around. I think he would try to catch these cockroaches first, because he is a little bit of a hunter. But then he's going to start running around trying to find more stones. And there's not really any over here, because he's already gone through and kind of collected all the stones he can find here. So I think he would leave Nightfrost sleeping where she is, and I think he would come over to this field and start collecting up the stones he can find over here, and maybe even wandering further afield if he feels like that's not enough fish for him to be able to take care of everything over at Branch Clan. So we'll come back over here once he's done hunting for that. I want to see Briarstalk. Briarstalk is actually, oh, he's really curious about the new kids. He is a little bit of a sucker when it comes to new kids, and he does want to groom Crowfeather and be best friends with Crowfeather. What does Crowfeather want to do? Crowfeather's also a little bit of a sucker for the kits, but he is also wanting to sniff and spend some time with Oakpaw. So let's pop over to Oakpaw.
who just is kind of like on his own. I think the Moss Clan cats feel pretty touched that they showed up at the special moment where some kits were born and they actually got to see Bearglow's reputation. Oakpaw's probably even more confused about that, but they got to see that Bearglow's reputation as a really powerful medicine cat might have a little bit of validity because he was able to save Glowkit from dying. All right, and then what's going on over here? Sandkit and Wildpaw are playing together. How adorable is that? That's so adorable. Look at the little sister bond. Oh my gosh, you guys don't have the same color eye. I wonder if anyone's ever gonna notice that. Compare you as sisters. But yeah, it looks like the sisters are playing around. Yeah, I think Dawn Step is just kind of cranky, so we'll let her go ahead and play with her sibling. And Branch Star is resting. He's curious about the new kits too, and he wants to play with Shellkit. He does want to socialize with Barstock. We'll worry about that in a little bit. Now, what's Moonpaw up to? I feel like Moonpaw might be getting a teeny bit antsy, because it's like she's never allowed to really do any training because Branch Star is so busy. So actually being a leader and having an apprentice is proving to be harder for Bearglow than he anticipated. Lion Star's not really run into that problem because all of the kits over there are Lion Star's kits. All right, so he's never tried to like mentor them himself. All right, and we're going to grab Shellkit. We're going to grab Stonepaw. And we're going to bring him over here to start looking for more of the rare rocks. So let's have him come over. Let's make sure he doesn't get hit by any monsters on Thunderpath. We'll get a little cat's eye view as we run this way. All right, monsters? Nope. Monsters? Nope. Really, like, Branch Clan kind of lucks out because they live so far off of the main roads. They don't really have... There goes a monster. Ah. See, they don't really live on the main road, so they don't ever really have a problem with that. But there sometimes is a problem up at Moss Clan with the monsters because Moss Clan happens to live next to that busy park. But after the meteors hit, I think the park is going to lose its status as a park because there was a forest fire right next to there. You know what I mean? All right, and let's see if we can take care of you. All right, anything for you to do over here, buddy? All right, here's a rock. So we're going to focus on Stonekit for a little bit today as well, because it is his opportunity to hopefully become, and we're going to come over here, it is his opportunity to hopefully work on gaining his warrior skills. Aha! Ooh, this one looks like a good one! Over here, Stonepaw, over here! Aha! There's two good ones! Man, we'll really luck out if those both prove to be moonstones, because then we'll be able to collect them. Alright, so as long as he's over here, then we can just send Slate over to collect these, because now that they're best friends, we don't have to have him mark or sniff Slate every single time that he wants to do that. There we go. Alright, good. And then let's see what else is around here. Any more? As long as we're on the lot. Ha! Look over here! Come over here! Come over here! Oh, Stonepaw, you really might luck out and be able just to keep the prey pile totally full. He's a very smart cat. Oh, yes, moonstones! Boom! Stonepaw, I think you're going to do it. You're going to be able to get all of these. It's going to be amazing. I think he might even collect the flowers. You know what? I think he's going to collect those flowers for his mom. He's going to pick those azaleas so that his mom can have them. In fact, we're gonna say we actually have... Let me come over here. We actually have back at Branch Clan some wildflowers that popped up. These sulfur wildflowers. I'm going to pretend those are the azaleas. Why is there like... I thought there's like cat vomit all over the place. Why? We'll move these sulfur flowers into the nursery where Dawnstep usually hangs out. And we'll say that Stonepaw brought them for his mom. So we'll have them nuzzle and raise relationship with those two when we come back. So we'll do that. Stonepaw, what else should you do over here? Any more things? I wonder if he would bring back, you know, on a collecting mission, I could see him bringing back a spotlight mushroom to offer to Bearglow, but I don't think any of the cats know what to do with it. So we'll say he gets distracted. We'll have him stalk for prey for a second. See if he gets any food. There's new kits to be sniffed. Everyone's really curious about Glowkit. I guess everyone's really worried. Look at all those moonstones! Stonepaw, you are like so lucky. And there's a rock over here that you just saw. So we can send Slate over to collect that one. So yeah, it's kind of Stonepaw's day to shine and walk around. And there's so many seeds and flowers around here. I wonder when Moss Clan is going to start saying, hey, this is like stuff we need too, because they're the ones who really need to collect all these flowers. I mean, a certain somebody is expecting some kits and Greenleaf. and she really loves honey, so I could see how somebody might be coming down and gathering up these flowers in order to get lots of honey, so that a certain honey lover might have a snack. All right, are you going to get some food? I really want to go back and spend time with our guest, but it looks like they're napping. So as long as the two guests are napping, and Crowfeather, what do you want to do? Sniff glow kit. Even Crowfeather is napping. All right, is that food? Yeah, he got the rhinoceros beetle. Sweet. I think that he'd actually... No! No, you can't eat it over here. That's no good. That's no good. Can we present it? Present to Slate and put it on the ground and then eat it as a result? Slate, your presence has actually proven to be quite useful because we need to eat this. All right, and eat it. There we go. All right, and Slate's happy. And Stonepaw gets to eat as a result. So we'll let Stonepaw eat and then maybe come over here and scratch this afterward. And then we'll do another quick search. I don't see any more rocks. I think Stonepaw, is that a rock? Yeah, there's a rock right there. I mean, there's a rock right there, but that's not the kind that you collect. Yeah, I think Stonepaw would be pretty thorough at searching for these stones. But the moonstones are going to be a huge boost because, yeah, he'll come over and he'll find this stone afterward. And, yeah, we'll say he dug around in here and found this. The moonstones are going to offer so many fish because they're worth so much. So can you get that, Slate? And then we'll let Stonepaw go home. And as long as we can keep, and we'll have to see what happens, but as long as we can keep the prey pile full, then he's going to have earned his warrior cat name. So good on you, Stonepaw. And then we'll have to come back over here and figure out what to do with the drama of everybody visiting and kits being born left and right. And really, we need to see what Sea Whisper is going to do. So we'll have to see if Sea Whisper will be willing to go and speak with Branch Star to get that fairy damsel fish. And we're going to have to see whether or not... What are you doing? Training fatigue? Since when have you been training? Sniff Glow Kit? I think he's a little bit curious about Glow Kit as well. And then we'll have to see if Bear Glow will offer the fairy damsel that's inside of the chest that he has in his medicine den. Because if he does that, then we have enough fairy damsels to give all of the potential, because you can have up to four kits. All of the potential kits that Sea Whisper could have would then potentially survive. Oh, why does she have fleas? Oh, that's going to drive Bergalo nuts. He hates fleas. He really hates fleas. Oh, and I decided that we can actually trade for the sea sludge by trading Bergalo's supply of grapes. So three grapes is equal to one sea sludge is what I thought. And if you guys think that's okay, then let me know. But I think three grapes to one sea sludge is pretty fair. So Bear Glow will kind of have a thing for the grapes that are, well, actually you only get like one. He harvested like tons of grapes, and oh well, we used some grapes for something, didn't we? Okay. Yeah, I think that three grapes per sea sludge is okay and fair-ish. We really need some rodents. That's kind of Branch Clan's problem, is they have a hard time keeping the fleas down. All right, so we're gonna come over here. We're going to come back home. Sorry if we seem a little bit distracted today. It's another one of those days where I'm having to like pick the one cat to focus on and then focus on them. And then we're just going to let him fish. And actually, we're going to come over. We're going to bring him back to be able to come back to his mentor. I totally forgot. He's going to remember all of a sudden like, oh yeah, we need to go see if Nightfrost has woken up. So, all right, come on, Stonepaw. Let's make sure you get across. Today is kind of the day to help focus on Stonepaw, if you guys are really curious about why we're doing that. All right, if he'll ever be able to, I think he'll be able to run over there. And Nightfrost once again is going to catch, it looks like, a spider. Oh, she changed her mind. All right, Stonepaw. As long as the creepy ice cream trucks don't show up, then you should be okay. All right, and there we go. Wonderful, so we got home, we got back here safely. So he'll go ahead and let Nightfrost know that he won't tell his dad, that he won't tell. But Bergalo, what are you doing over here? Bergalo, when did you get here? And bump into Nightfrost. And I wonder if he followed Nightfrost over, because he did say that Nightfrost shouldn't be doing some hunting. And maybe he came over to gather some grapes because he really, really, really hates fleas. All right. Well, Stonepaw, you go ahead and actually offer your mentor. Are we not on the clan territory? There we go. Offer her the stag beetle. So we're going to increase their relationship a little bit. It's actually as good as it can get. And he's going to say, here, you can have the stag beetle. I'm sorry you had to come out even though you're not feeling good. We're going to let her go ahead and eat. There you go, you guys. And then Berglo, I guess, is over here to nap and then do his collection of some things for the medicine den. All right. And then where is Sea Whisper? Sea Whisper's doing okay other than those nasty fleas. And let's check out the new kits because they were just bored. Coral Kit, where are you? Oh, you're snoozing over here. So Coral Kit wanted to sleep in the proper moss bed. Forget the other stuff. Briarstalk's almost awake. And let's see, Crowfeather. Crowfeather, goof around. Let's have Crowfeather go ahead. And I think he might do a little bit of fishing. There's Quail Eye. Or congratulate. I think he would congratulate Quail Eye on the fact that there's now kits involved. Oh, and Quail Eye wants to groom a kit. Well, imagine that. Oh, and he also wants to master the hunting skill. I totally forgot about that. So we'll have him come over because I think he's kind of feeling like there's suddenly four kits that he more or less has a very important responsibility to take care of. And it is a full moon night, so we might do a gathering, we might not. Because Moss Clan is still recovering from the fact that they had the meteor show up. I don't know if they're ready for a gathering just yet. That may be why they sent Briarstalk and Oakpaw to be representatives. No. No, Lisa. I'm sorry, Lisa. Bye, Lisa. That's not how we're doing this. Yeah, bye, Lisa. Crowfeather, don't worry about that. It's zombies. You see them all the time in Moss Clan. It's not a big deal. All right, and Quail Eye is off to take care of himself. Sniff Dawn Step. I wonder if Crowfeather might do a little bit. Ah, good. Briarstalk's up. So we're going to come over. Friendly, socialize. And Briarstalk wants to play with a catnip toy. And he really wants to, like, groom Crowfeather. It seems like Briarstalk is really invested in trying to convince Crowfeather. Like, hang in there, buddy. You can come back to Moss Clan very soon here. So we'll let these two bond now. All right. And let's see. Nightfrost. Nightfrost is doing okay. She's ready to go home. She ate. And Stonepaw? All right. And Stonepaw is working his way back home. So I think that he's going to come over here, pee here, and then even sleep here to show his dad how, if that's not enough, he'll head back out and he'll kind of guard the entrance because he takes things very seriously. And we have only got two fish left in the prey pile. So let's go ahead and see what Slate is going to offer up. Slate's excited. He's been eating lots of yummy gems. All right, so that's one. So you can put down one fish. It wasn't a very expensive emerald, so we only get one little anchovy. And then we got a lot of moonstones. One topaz. So again, a teensy little anchovy. And then, let's see. Let's go for the cheaper stuff first. This is some gold. We'll just roll up one, so it's like dig up. Sewer trilobite. And then two tiny space rocks. Let's get rid of those before you get abducted. Please, Slate. I don't need that happening in this particular series. There's one. There's two. So there's a few fish. And that doesn't really help as much as we thought. So, you know, what Stonepaw might do is actually keep the prey pile full manually by catching lots of prey from the ocean as well. So this is going to be worth 5 because it was 544 Simoleonians. So that means we're going to grab 1, then 2, 3. Why not grab some swordfish? 4. 5. I hope that was enough. I lost count partway. But then, see, this one is worth 667, so we would round up and it would be worth 7 fish. But the prey pile is looking pretty robust right now, but I think that Stonepaw would be very aware because he's getting better and better at kind of associating himself with the abilities as the spirit of the land for stones. The fact that he can give all of these stones to Slate, but stones are not really an infinite resource. It's not really an infinite resource. They show up every now and then when they pop up out of the ground. So he has to be aware that he can only collect so many of them at a time, and that Slate only has so many fish to offer him at a time. So I think that he would still take his duty to advance his hunting skill very seriously. So that's what he's going to be doing. And how are the other new kits? So many kits. You guys know having this many kits means that all of the random events that could occur to those kits are going up and up and up. And I think Oakpaw has a bit of a soft spot for kits. Oh, what's Trout Shadow doing over here? And Trout Shadow really needs to hurry up. He's got a soft spot for kits, but he needs to hurry up and offer that frog to Sea Whisper and give those blowfish and that sea sludge to his medicine cat. I think he's going to get pounced by somebody and told, hey, be a good warrior. He's a little bit distractible. All right, so I think that's it for now. New kits born. perfect sparkling scaly jellyfish being caught by Slate all of the time. And it looks like right over here, Briarstalk is really, really, really determined to spend quite a bit of time working with Crowfeather and letting Crowfeather know that Moss Clan misses them. So I think they're sharing tongues and catching one another up on all of the Moss Clan gossip. And oh my gosh, are you kidding me, Sea Whisper? Oh, hang on. All right, she is actually okay, you guys. It's just that the pregnancy is really rough on her as usual. So we'll have to wake her up and we will have to remember to have her eat those two fairy damselfish so that she's eaten four of them to protect her future kits. Because this is a really hard pregnancy on her. I don't know if she's really made for this, and I really hope she survives because she does have a higher chance than usual of dying each time she gives birth to one of the kits. So we'll have to see what happens, and we'll have to see when she gives birth to them, because I think tomorrow is going to be the time for Greenleaf, aka Summer, to come in, and that's when Crowfeather needs to make his decision. And as much as he's had a wonderful time learning about the sea with Sea Whisper, he is being filled in on all of the friends, the companions, the cats that he grew up with and fought side by side with for the past several seasons right now. And what choice do you guys think he should make? So we'll have to see, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye. And just for the record, "we'll have to see" was not meant to be a pun about Sea Whisper. Okay, I'm going to go now.